Hello, my name is Erin. This tutorial shows how to insert headers and footers on specific pages in Microsoft Word. For example, you may want to have a different header and footer for each chapter in your document. We'll also look at how to remove the header and footer from the first page of your document or the first page of a section. If you need a refresher on inserting, editing, and deleting headers and footers, please see my previous tutorial titled How to Insert Headers and Footers in Microsoft Word, which is linked in the description box below. Today I'll be using Word for Microsoft 365. These steps also apply to previous versions of the software, back to Word 2013 and Word for Mac. The following steps will work in documents with or without existing headers and footers. To begin, select the Home tab in the ribbon. Next, select the Show Hide button to show your formatting marks. Now, select the Layout tab in the ribbon. And then place your cursor at the beginning of the page where you want the new header or footer to start. I'm going to place my cursor here at the beginning of Chapter 2 because I want to change the header from Chapter 1 to Chapter 2. Once your cursor is in place, select the Breaks button in the Page Setup group, followed by Next Page from the drop-down menu. A section break should appear at the bottom of the previous page. Next, double-click in the header or footer area of the page where you want the new headers or footers to start. Double-clicking opens the Header and Footer tab, which only appears when the headers or footers are selected. Now, deselect the Link to Previous button to disconnect the headers or footers in the section you just created from the previous section. It's important to note that deselecting the Link to Previous button only disconnects the headers or footers. It doesn't disconnect the headers and footers. The Link to Previous button will also disconnect any page numbers in the headers or footers. Please see my other tutorial titled How to Insert Page Numbers on Specific Pages in Microsoft Word for more information. If you don't have an existing header or footer, select the Header or Footer button in the Header and Footer group. And then select a style from the drop-down menu. Next, type your information in the header or footer placeholders. If you do have existing headers or footers, you don't have to select the Header or Footer button. Instead, you can just replace the existing text. When you're finished, select the Close Header and Footer button. Repeat the previous steps until you've created new headers or footers in each of your sections as necessary. And then select the Home tab and reselect the Show Hide button to hide your formatting marks. You may want to remove the header and footer from the first page of your document, if it's a cover page, or the first page of the section, if it's a title page. Please note that removing the header and footer will also remove the existing page number from the first page of the document or section. To begin, place your cursor in the first page of the document or the first page of the section. And then double-click inside the header or footer area to open the Header and Footer tab. From there, select Different First Page in the Options group. The header and footer should be removed from the first page of the document or section. When you're finished, select the Close Header and Footer button. And as always, remember to save your file to save your changes. I have created many other videos about Microsoft Word, including how to insert and delete a blank page in Microsoft Word, and how to save tables and figures as images in Microsoft Word. Please see the complete list in the playlists titled How to Use Microsoft Word and How to Use Word for Mac, which are linked in the description box below. All the steps we just performed are listed with images on AaronWriteWriting.com, along with all my other writing-related software tutorials to help you succeed at work and in the classroom. Feel free to leave me a comment if there's a specific topic that you'd like me to talk about in the future. And please subscribe to my channel so you don't miss future tutorials. And give this video a thumbs up if you found it helpful. Thank you so much for watching.